Sri Krishna as Samsaarin. When Devarishi Narada heard that Narakasura was killed by Sri Krishna and that Sri Krishna had married 16,000 princesses simultaneously, he wanted to see the divine glory, the wonder of wonders, the yoga maya of the Lord. He came to Dwarka and entered each and every house and found Sri Krishna in each and every one, attending to different duties at different places at the same time among different persons. First, he saw Sri Krishna in one house sitting on his cushion and being fanned by Rukmini. As soon as Sri Krishna saw Narada, he ran up to him, received him, brought him and made him sit on his own seat. He washed his feet, gave him new clothes, a cow, etc., sprinkled the water on his own head and inquired of Narada the service that he could do to him, though he knew the purpose of Narada's visit. In another house, Narada saw Sri Krishna consulting with Uddhava. There again, he was received by him with due respect and inquired as to what service Sri Krishna could do to Narada. In another house, he was seen bathing and offering prayers. In another, he was making japa and meditation. In another, he was worshipping Brahmins. In another, he was offering food to Brahmins. In another, taking the sacred prasad. In another, he was planning for peace. In another, he was planning to destroy an enemy. In every house, he was present, looking after a separate duty within the bounds of dharma, artha, kama and moksha. Having seen all these, Narada finally requested Sri Krishna, "O Lord, give me strength to withstand the play of your yoga maya on me. Let me always have the capacity to be singing your praise." Sri Krishna replied, "Narada, I am the preceptor of dharma. I preach dharma. I practice dharma in the world so that others may follow my example. Therefore, do not be deluded that I am a samsarin. I am active, etc." Having seen enough of these wonders, Narada took leave of Sri Krishna and went his own way. Sri Krishna's daily routine of work was as follows. He would wake up from bed 2.5 hours before sunrise, that is in the Brahma Muhurtam, have a wash and sit for meditation on the self with a serene mind and in the calm atmosphere. When this was over, he would go for a bath, put on fresh clothes, perform sandhya, Gayatri Japa, offer fire worship and perform Surya Namaskar, offer oblations to gods, means, and the rishis. Then he would worship the elders, father, mother, brother, etc., and the Brahmins. He would give presents to Brahmins in the shape of money and other articles of utility. He would bestow presents to servants, subjects, and his own ladies. He would salute the cows, Brahmins, etc. Then he would dress up and proceed to the Darbar hall in his chariot. He would sit there as the personification of Dharma and inquire into petitions. The court would be full with learned Brahmins who could expound Vedic mantras and Manusutras besides the other courtiers. The people would forget all their wants and observe the proceedings till the court was over.